Hello everyone, let's try to be a cheat code ninja today. We'll be looking at a very interesting graph problem where we are given an undirected tree and some of these nodes contain an apple which is represented by the hasApples array. It is given that we take 1 second to cover one edge of this tree and we have to find the minimum time in seconds that we have to spend to collect all the apples starting from vertex 0 and again returning back over there. Let's look at the example given. We are given that nodes 2, 4 and 5 contain apples. And to collect all the apples, we have to start at node 0. We'll first go to node 4, taking 2 seconds. Then we'll go back to node 1 in 1 step. Now we'll go to node 5 in 1 step. From there, we'll take 2 steps to reach node 0. And finally, we'll require 2 steps to go to node 2 and then return back. Please note that we didn't have to go to these two nodes because they didn't have any apples and going there would require extra steps. So the total number of steps required would be 8. Let's try to come up with an intuitive solution for this. Let's try to understand more about this problem using this example. Let's see what happens every time we try to pick an apple and then go back to a root of the tree and then go on a different direction to pick another apple. For example, to pick the apple at node 3, we would require to go 4 steps. 2 steps to reach there and 2 steps to come back. Similarly, to pick the apple from node 4, we would require 4 steps. So we'd require 8 steps in total. If you notice, we are going over the same edges multiple times. So probably we can cut down on some repetitive work. If we look at these two nodes which contain an apple, it would make sense to have a delivery hub as close as possible to them. Node 1 is their lowest common ancestor. So it would make sense for both of these apples to be stored over there and from node 1 they can be together shipped back to node 0. In this way, the cost of the travel will only be 6 steps, so this is more optimal. Now let's compare these two nodes. Both these nodes do not have any apples in them. But for node 1, at least one of its nodes in its subtree has an apple inside it, so it is necessary to travel through it. But for node 2, neither it nor one of the nodes in its subtree have any apples in them. So there is no point to travel through it. So we only travel to a node which either has an apple in it or one of the nodes in its subtree has an apple. Let's take the case when one of the nodes in the subtree of 2 has an apple. In that case, we have to travel through both these nodes to collect it. Let's try to calculate the distance we have to travel to reach any node. For node 1, we have to travel 2 steps from node 0 to reach it and then go back. If we take node 3 and node 4, since we have seen that it makes more sense to travel from a common hub, it would take 2 steps for both of them to reach there and then go back. So for each node, there will be 2 types of costs associated. One will be the cost to reach there from its nearest hub, and the other one will be the cost to collect all the apples from its subtree. For node 1, node 0 will be its nearest hub, and the cost to reach there will be 2. It also has 2 apples in its subtree and the cost to collect them will be 4. The total cost for this node will be the sum of these two, so it would take 6 steps in total. If we go to its parent, node 0, the cost to travel to it would be 0. And since it has only one child with apples in its subtree, that will be the cost to collect all the apples from its subtree. And when we sum these two, we'll get our final answer. Let's try this approach on our original example. Our answer will be the cost to collect all the apples from node 0. In this case, the cost to travel there would be 0. And for finding the cost for its subtree, we'll use the same recursive approach for each of the child nodes. For both these nodes, the cost to travel would be plus 2. For the right node, it doesn't have any apple in its subtree, so the cost to collect apples from its subtree would be 0. For the left child, there are 2 nodes in its subtree which have apples in them. So we'll try to calculate the same for its child nodes. For both these nodes, the cost to travel from the nearest hub would be plus 2. And since they have no apples in their subtrees, the cost would be 0. So we'll sum the results of these two and this will be the cost for the subtree of node 1. So the total cost for node 1 will be plus 6 and for node 2, it would be plus 2. This will be the cost to collect the apples from the subtree of node 0. And once we add these two, we'll get our answer. The time complexity of this would be O of n because we only have to go through the nodes once. And the space complexity would be O of n because of a recursive call stack. Let's implement our solution. The first thing that we'll do is create an adjacency matrix to store our graph. So we'll go through each pair of edges And since this is an undirected graph, we'll store two entries in our adjacency matrix. Now we'll implement our recursive DFS function, which takes in the current node, the previous node, and the cost to reach there as input parameters. For each node, we have to calculate the cost of collecting the apples from its subtree. Hence, we'll keep a variable for that and initialize it to 0. For current node, we'll go through all its child nodes. Since the previous node from which we arrived will also be one of the neighbors, we'll skip it to avoid a cycle. For each child node, we'll calculate the subtree cost and add it to the subtree cost for this node. We'll call the same DFS function, where this child node will become the current node and our current node will become the previous node. And since it would take 2 steps to travel to this child node from our current node, the own cost would be 2. One thing we have to be careful about is that if a node does not have an apple and none of its subtrees has an apple, in that case we'll skip that node. So if the subtree cost is 0 and our current node doesn't have an apple, then we'll return 0. So finally, the cost for this current node as hub will be the sum of the cost to reach there and the cost to collect the apples from its subtrees. We are now done with our DFS function. Let's call it for node 0 with the previous node as none and the cost to travel as 0. We are done with our solution. Let's submit it. You can see our solution is accepted. If you have any doubts or concerns regarding this solution, please mention in the comments. If you thought this video was helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more such content. Thanks for watching.